हेलो एवरीवन, इस पूरी सीरीज के अंदर हम पूरे सिलेबस को कवर करेंगे ऑन डिजिटल लॉजिक। और डिजिटल लॉजिक के अंदर जितने भी सिलेबस है, पूरा जो स्टार्टिंग से एंड तक हम पूरा टॉपिक जो है सब कवर करेंगे, और उसके साथ साथ हम कुछ प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस को भी यहाँ पर कवर करेंगे। तो आई होप जो क्लासेस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा। तो आई थिंक यू नो माई नेम, माई नेम इज़ हिमांशु कौशिक, और मुझे गेट की फील्ड में स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाते हुए बहुत टाइम हो चुका है। मैं इंडिया के बेस्ट इंस्टीट्यूशंस के साथ ऑलरेडी काम कर चुका हूँ, और सब पहली बार मैंने गेट एग्ज़ाम क्लियर किया था, दैट वॉज इन 2011-12। तो ऑब्वियसली आप देख सकते हो कि इसी फील्ड में मुझे लगभग 10 साल से ज़्यादा एक्सपीरियंस हो चुका है। तो ऑब्वियसली हमारा जो एक्सपीरियंस है आपके लिए काफ़ी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा, तो इसी वजह से आप जो हमारी क्लासेस है उसको ज्वाइन कर सकते हैं। और अगर आप मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं ऑन अन अकेडमी, तो अन अकेडमी पे मेरे पास दो तरह के कोर्सेज जो होते हैं। पहला जो है दैट इज़ कॉल्ड प्लस कोर्स, एंड सेकेंड इज़ आइकॉनिक कोर्स। तो प्लस कोर्स में स्पेशल ये है कि यहाँ पर इंडिया के बेस्ट टीचर्स यहाँ पर होते हैं, और साथ साथ में जो मेरी क्लासेस होती है काफ़ी इंट्रैक्टिव होती है, यानी कि आप और मैं क्लासेस के बीच में इंट्रैक्टिव या डिस्कशन हम लोग कर सकते हैं। और साथ साथ में जब आप आइकॉनिक कोर्स में जाएंगे तो आइकॉनिक में स्पेशल है, स्पेशल ये है कि एक मेंटर आपके साथ हमेशा साथ रहेगा। तो मेंटर, जब भी आपको कोई भी डाउट रहेगा, आपको कोई भी नोट्स की ज़रूरत होगी या फिर आपको कोई मोटिवेशन की ज़रूरत होगी, तो मेंटर हमेशा आपको सपोर्ट करेगा इन एनी वे। तो अगर मेरा कोई भी कोर्स लेना चाहते हैं विद अन अकेडमी, चाहे आप प्लस ले या फिर आइकॉनिक ले, मेरा कोई भी कोर्स अगर आप लेना चाहते हैं, जस्ट यूज़ अ कूपन कोड विच इज़ कौशिक 10, क्योंकि कौशिक 10 में आपको टोटल 10% ऑफ हमको मिल जाएगा। जस्ट यूज दिस एंड होप यू लाइक दिस। पूरी सीरीज जो है आपको बहुत अच्छी लगेगी, एंड थैंक यू सो मच। हेलो एवरीवन, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव सीन एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू बुलियन अलजेब्रा, एंड वी हैव सीन हाउ कैन यू मिनिमाइज द बुलियन एक्सप्रेशंस यूजिंग द आइडेंटिटीज ऑफ बुलियन अलजेब्रा। हम बुलियन एक्सप्रेशंस को किस तरीके से मिनिमाइज कर सकते हैं यूजिंग द आइडेंटिटीज, वो हम पिछले वीडियो में, पिछले सेशन में हम ऑलरेडी देख चुके हैं। नाउ इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मिनिमाइजेशन ऑफ बुलियन एक्सप्रेशंस यूजिंग के मैप्स। वाई डू वी नीड के मैप्स? दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट यू नीड टू आंसर। सो समटाइम्स इफ यू हैव बिग एक्सप्रेशंस, सो मिनिमाइजिंग दोज बिग एक्सप्रेशन टेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, प्लस देर आर ह्यूज चांसेस, देर आर वेरी हाई चांसेस दैट minimization of boolean expression, during that minimization you are going to make mistakes. So that is why we are using these k-maps. With the help of k-maps it will be very easy for us to minimize an expression. k-maps ki help se kisi expression ko minimize karna hamare liye bahut easy ho jayega, it will be very easy for all of us. So this topic will approximately take us 4 to 5 hours to complete, because there are a lot of examples that we need to take within. I mean, it is important for us to cover all of these examples. If you will not cover examples, then the topic will not be very clear. So we will do the following things today. First of all, we are going to look at an introduction. So that is the introduction to the k-map. What is the basic structure of k-map? How can you make a k-map for any expression? I'm going to take everything step by step. Even if in some point, if you feel that I'm using a lot of presentations, a lot of PPTs, don't worry about it, just follow through the lectures, you will understand everything step by step. Dekho, kafi baar aisa hota hai, we Indians, we are not designed to study using PPTs or presentations. We are trained to study on a whiteboard or on a notebook. आपके स्कूल लेवल में, कॉलेज लेवल में ऐसा होता था कि जो टीचर्स हैं वो आपको बचपन से ही, आई मीन फ्रॉम योर LKG, UKG, नर्सरी ऑनवर्ड्स, एंड एवरीवन इज टीचिंग यू ऑन अ ब्लैक बोर्ड और अ वाइट बोर्ड टिल इन योर यू नो BTech एंड MTech. बट यूजिंग द प्रेजेंटेशंस इज नॉट वेरी कन्वीनियंट फॉर अस, बिकॉज वी आर नॉट रियली डिजाइंड टू यू नो, वी आर नॉट having any kind of practice to study using presentations. That is why even if I show a few things using the presentations, just follow through the lectures, because I'm also going to cover some few example based on those. And once you complete this entire chapter, jab tak aap pura chapter ko complete karenge, you will be able to understand everything in a very crystal clear manner. Okay, just follow through the lectures, you will understand everything. So the first one will be introduction to the k-maps. How can you make the k-maps? Second is, we are going to take some examples using representing the functions using k-maps, representing the functions using KMap, or you can say representing Boolean expressions using KMap. And third, we are going to look at what are the prime implicants, what are essential prime implicants, right? And what are just implicants? Because if we know what are implicants, what are prime implicants, what are essential prime implicants, it will become very easy for us to minimize any Boolean expression. And then again, we will take a lot of examples. I will take a lot of examples so that every topic, everything should be crystal clear with you guys. Aap sabhi ke saath sabhi cheeze bilkul acche se crystal clear honi chahiye. Okay? Let us do an introduction. I mean, how can you make K-maps? Okay, so basically K-map is dependent on a very simple expression, jo aapki Boolean expression hoti hai. So in, you know, there are some identities of Boolean expression. So you have an identity that if you do A plus A complementation, then it is equal to 1. Based on this principle, the entire K-map is designed. So ye jo principle hai aapko, you already know this principle. We have already taken a lot of examples based on these principles. And just based on these principles, K-maps are designed. Let us look at a few examples, then you will understand step by step what I'm trying to say. Okay. So we have to cover the following things. So this is just an example of K-map. This is how the K-map will look like. And I'm just showing you this as a picture because later on you will understand what I'm trying to represent using this. Hum isse kya represent karne ki koshish kar rahe hain, wo baad mein samjhenge. We will come back to this later on. So let us leave it as it is and I'll come back to this one. Okay. And again, you will understand this one also later on. Ye kaise represent kiya hai, kya represent kiya hai. We are going to look at all of these things one by one. Okay. So let us skip these parts first of all. Okay. Fine. So let's start from here. So K-map is basically a graphical way of solving Boolean expressions. K-map se hum Boolean expressions ko ek graphical way se solve karte hain, right? Jaise if you have only one variable, you know that if you have only one variable, then with the help of this one variable, your function can take only two values. Either the value of a can be 0 or the value of a is 1. So this value of a 0 is represented by a complement and this value of 1 is represented by a, correct? Now if you have two variables, then there are total of 4 combinations. We have already seen this. So you can take a variable a, you can take a variable b, and with these two variables you have 4 combinations. You can have combinations as 0 0, 0 1, 1 0 and 1 1. So this 0 0 is representing a complement b complement. This is representing a complement b. This is representing a b complement. And when I say 1 1, this is representing a b. And with the help of 3 variables, there are 8 combinations are possible. Let us assume the 3 variables are a, b and c. So the combinations that are possible here are 0 0 0, 0 0 1, 0 1 0, 0 1 1, 1 0 0, 1 0 1, 1 1 0, 1 1 1. I hope it is visible. Aap sabhi ke saath visible hoga. Yes, it is visible. Okay. Now the first combination here is representing a complement b complement c complement. This is representing a complement b complement c. This is representing a complement b c complement. This is representing a b c. Okay. A complement b c. This is representing a b complement c complement. It is representing a b complement c. This is representing a b c complement, and this one is representing a b c. So these are all the combinations, correct? I hope all of these combinations are visible. Yes, it is visible. Now when I take this K map which is having only one variable, so I am representing this a complement using this cell and I'm representing this A using this. Okay? So hum A complement ko is cell se represent kar rahe hain, which is 0, and I'm representing A with this cell. Fine. And when I have two variables, right? So these two variables can take 4 combinations, right? So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So this cell is representing 0, 0, 0, and 0. This cell is representing 0, 1. This cell is representing 1, 0. and this cell is representing 1 1. Okay, and now here when you have three variables, so the combination with the three variables are total 8 combinations. So that means you can see the total of 8 cells here. This first cell is representing 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 and 0 1 0. This is representing 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 and 1 1 0. Okay. There's something very interesting to notice here, something very interesting, that when you create these combinations, I can also give them some decimal values. Okay, so I can allocate them some decimal values. So the decimal value of 000 is 0. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, then we have 6, and then we have 7. So we have all the decimal values, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But if you look at this cell, now these values are in, these combinations are given in a different manner. What do I mean to say by different manner? So if you just look at these combinations and you try to see what cell is representing which combination, then you can also represent it with the help of a decimal number. So this is representing a decimal number 0, this is representing a decimal number 1, this is representing 2, and this is 3. This is 4, this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. Okay, now why I do not have 1 2 0 1 2 3, but why I have 0 1 3 2 is tarike se kyun hai, and here also we have 4 5 7 6, we do not have 6 7. The reason is the K-map uses gray code. Okay, gray code ka matlab kya, what do I mean to say by gray code? Gray code means between any two combinations which are adjacent to each other, we should have only one bit as a different, right? Only but one bit should be different. Jaise ki, let me show you with the help of an example. Let me try to show you. So if I say that we have the first bit is 000, then second is 001. So between these two, only one bit is different. Yahan par sirf ek hi bit ka difference hai, only one bit is different. Correct. If I say 010, now in this case between these two combination there is a gap difference of 2 bits, so this bit is changing from 1 to 0 as well as this bit is changing from 0 to 1. Now in K maps we only, any two adjacent cells can have a change of only one bit, they can have only one bit as a change, that is called as a gray code. Okay, that means Instead of using this combination, I can use the following combination. I can have 011. Because if I use 011, then between these two bits, between these two combinations, I mean this entire combination and this entire combination, there's a change of only one bit. This is presenting a decimal value 0. This is presenting a decimal value 1. This is presenting a decimal value 3. There's a change of only one bit. In the same way, if I take 010, so between this one and this one there's a change of only one bit, sirf ek hi bit ka change hai, and I can write it as 2. Main isko 2 likh sakta hun. Okay, so in the same way this entire K map is organized, pura K map jo hai wo isi principle pe organized hai. So if I just again write the decimal values, then the decimal values will be 000 001 011 1010. This is 100 101 111 and 110. If you take any two adjacent cells, aap koi bhi randomly do adjacent cell lijiye, take any two random adjacent cell, maybe I'm taking these two cells. If I'm taking these two cells, there's a change of only one bit. If I'm taking these two cells, there's a change of only one bit, right? So only one bit is changed. Even if I try to take these two cells, still there's a change of only one bit, yani ki row mein aur column mein. So whenever we have a row and whenever we have a column, any two adjacent cells are having a change of only one bit. And now here this adjacent cell is also having a change of one bit. Even these two adjacent cells are having a change of only one bit. So that is why we use gray code here to represent the K-map. Now what is the benefit of using the gray code? Gray code ka jo benefit hai wo kya hai? What is the benefit of using the gray code here? Let's try to understand the benefit here step by step. Okay, so let us assume we have this function. Let us start with the smaller function here, So this is a smaller function, is a two variable function, and here this is a function f, correct? Now let us assume this function f is assuming a value 1 here, it is assuming a value 1 here, it is assuming a value 0 in these two cases. Do locations pe iski value 1 hai aur do locations par 0 hai. If I trace out these values, if I try to put these values in the K map, this is representing the combination 0 0, so this 1 will be here. This is representing the combination 0 1, therefore this 1 will be here, correct? And all other locations we are having 0, fine? And if you look at this combination is representing A combination, A complement, B complement. Kya represent kar raha hai? It's representing A complement, B complement. And this one is representing your A complement B. Fine. Now, for this function, the expression is something like this. A complement, B complement plus A complement B. I can take A complement as common. Then I will get B complement dot B, B complement plus B, which is equal to A complement only. So, jo pura function hai, this entire function can be represented by a single A complement. हम पूरे function को सिर्फ A complement की help से represent कर सकते हैं, right? Now coming back to this K map, here I can combine these two cells together. If I am combining these two cells together, all I have to say is what is the bit that is changing, because A is remaining constant, only B is changing. So the bits, the variable which is changing its value, I can eliminate that variable, and the variable which is not changing its value, I can say it is A complementation. So we can just A complement se represent kar sakte hain. That is why even using this, I can find the same solution. Let me explain you with this one. Okay? Here what I can do is, I can have a combination 1 here, I can have a 1 here, I can have 1 here, and I can have a 1 here. Let us assume these four locations we are having a 1 and these other locations we are having a 0. So let me also represent the same with the help of this function. Let me rub this one. So let me also represent with the help of the truth table. Let's go truth table se bhi represent karta hun so that it becomes easier for all of you guys. Okay? So in this case, this function is assuming a value 1 here. Ye kaun si location hai? 0, 1. Right? So here also this function is having value 1. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So in the location 6 and 7, it is assuming a value 1. Otherwise, in all other locations, it is having a value 0. Correct? Now, in this case, I can combine these two cells and I can combine these two cells. Why I can combine? Because these two adjacent cells are having a change of only 1 bit. And these two adjacent cells are having a change of only 1 bit. So for this cell, which bit is changing? This C is changing. B is remaining the same as well as A is also remaining the same. B bhi same hai aur A bhi same hai. A ki value kya hai aapke paas? 0. Aur B ki value kya dono cells ke liye? 0, 0. Therefore, this combination is representing A complement, B complement. Correct? In the same way, if you look at this combination here, here A is remaining the same. The value of A is only 1. And the value of B is also same, only these two values, which is C, the value of C is changing. Therefore, I can write this combination as AB. Main is combination kya kya likh sakta hu yahan par? AB. Therefore, if I represent this with the help of an expression, this will be A complement B complement plus AB, which is representing A XNOR B. A XNOR B. The same can be, you know, calculated using this. Truth table. इस truth table से भी हम इसको same को calculate कर सकते हैं. How can you calculate? Just take these combinations. तो ये जो combination है क्या represent कर रहा है? This is representing A complement, B complement, C complement plus this combination is representing A complement, B complement, C plus this combination is representing A, B, C complement plus this combination is representing A, B and C. From these two, I can take A complement, B complement as common. I can take A complement, B complement is common plus, and inside the bracket we are going to have C complement plus C plus, and from these two I can take AB as common, inside we are going to get C complement plus C, therefore this is 1, therefore we are going to get A complement, B complement plus AB. So you can clearly see this expression as well as this expression, both are exactly the same. Jo dono expressions hain, dono exactly same hain. So basically, if I represent a function using a k-map, so this is a graphical method, and solving the function using a graphical method makes things very clear for us, as well as it makes things very easy. As I said, human recognition memory, humans can understand using images. Aapko images zyada lambe time tak yaad rehti hai. You can remember images for a very, very long time. You can remember the faces of the people. You can remember the photo. You can remember a picture. But if I ask you to remember a paragraph from a newspaper, you will not be able to do it, because human mind is only designed to recognize patterns. It is only designed to recognize pictures. राइट तो हम लोग टेक्स्ट को, वैल्यूज को, नंबर्स को ज्यादा लंबे टाइम तक याद नहीं कर पाते हैं. ओके, नाउ अगेन हियर इन दिस केस यू कैन ऑल्सो सी दिस के मैप, एंड दिस इज अ फोर वेरिएबल के मैप. सो इफ यू टेक एनी टू एडजेसेंट सेल व्हाटसो एवर, एनी टू रैंडम एडजेसेंट सेल, जैसे जैसे आई कैन टेक दिस टू एडजेसेंट सेट, आई कैन टेक दिस टू एडजेसेंट सेल, दिस सेल इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग 1101, सो 1101, राइट, and this cell is representing 11 and 11, correct? So here you can see only one bit is changed. Yahan par sirf ek hi bit ka change hai, only one bit is changed. Hence why it is having only one bit is changed, because we are using gray code. To agar aap koi bhi do adjacent lenge cells in terms of row as well as in terms of column, only one bit will be changed. This is how we organize the k-map. Now in this k-map, if you check out their values, if you check out their values, this is representing 0000, this is 0001, this one is representing 0011, this is 0010, ye wala hai aapke paas 0100, 0101, 0111, 0110, 1100, 1101, 1111, 1110, 1000, 1001, 1011, 1010. Okay, these are the cells. So if you remember, if you try to represent them with the decimal values, agar aap inke decimal values ki tarah se represent karenge, this representing value is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So these are the decimal values. This is how I can represent a four variable k-map. इस तरीके से हम एक four variable k-map को represent कर सकते हैं. Clear? Okay. So four variable k-map will be having 16 cells. So here you can see what each of these cells are representing. If I have only one variable k-map, then one entry is representing A complement. The second entry is representing A. If I have two variable k-map, these entries are A complement, B complement, A complement B, AB complement, and AB. Correct. Here also, if you check between any two, you know, any two adjacent cells, they are having a change of only one bit. वहाँ पर हमारे पास सिर्फ एक ही bit का change है. Even if you can see three variable k map, you will be having a change of only one bit. Take any two random adjacent cell. Even if I take this cell, only one bit is changed. So here only B is changed, A is same, as well as C is changed. C is also same. Even if you take this one, only one bit is changing, that is A. यहाँ पर सिर्फ A ही चेंज कर रहा है, अदरवाइज B एंड C बोथ आर सेम. ओके, सो इन दिस वे यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट k-maps. ओके, आई होप इट इज क्लियर. क्लियर? सो वी हैव टू काइंड्स ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन, एज आई टोल्ड यू वी हैव मिनटर्म्स एज वेल एज वी हैव अ मैक्स टर्म. अगर हम लोग मिनटर्म्स की बात करेंगे, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द मिनटर्म्स, देन वी रिप्रेजेंट मिनटर्म्स एज ए सम ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. So they are representing all the product terms. If I talk about the max terms, that means they are representing product of sum. So yahan par jo hai, ye product of sum expressions hai. We will look at this later on. Isko hum log baad mein dekhte hain. We'll try to understand it, how ye kaise kaam karta hai. We'll try to understand it later on. Theek hai? Okay, let us move step by step. I'll take everything in a step by step manner, taki aapko koi bhi confusion na ho. I'll try to explain you with the help of with clarity. Okay, तो हम सब चीजें बिल्कुल clarity से लेंगे. Now there are two ways. I mean, here you can see in this is the k-map for three variables. This is the k-map for three variables. But the way you are going to represent the variables, that will change their values. ठीक है, जैसे what I'm trying to say is, let us suppose that we have a function f of a comma b comma c. मेरे पास क्या फंक्शन है, एफ ऑफ ए कॉमा बी कॉमा सी, एंड हियर दिस फंक्शन इज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज समीशन समीशन 1, 3, 6 एंड 7, राइट. आई होप दैट यू रिमेंबर दिस वन. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कवर्ड व्हाट इज समिशन. हमने अपनी प्रीवियस क्लास में समिशन को कवर किया था. ओके, नाउ लुक एट इट वेरी केयरफुली बिकॉज दिस इज अ लिटिल ट्रिकी थिंग्स. मेनी पीपल मेक मिस्टेक्स हियर. सो इफ आई एम रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए हियर एंड हियर बी सी देन इट विल बी डिफरेंट. एंड हियर इफ आई एम रिप्रेजेंटिंग सी हियर एंड हियर ए बी, नाउ दीज टू के मैप्स आर हैविंग फ्यू डिफरेंट वैल्यूज. ठीक है, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू. सो दिस इज ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड दिस इज ए, दिस इज बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी, बी सी एंड बी सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. एंड दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड सी. दिस इज ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट बी, ए बी एंड दिस इज ए बी कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन. ओके, एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रिप्रेजेंट द विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ नंबर, आप इसको नंबर से भी रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं. दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ नंबर जीरो, दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ नंबर वन. ओके, तो ये जो है ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट, ये नंबर जीरो को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है. एंड व्हेन आई से ए, ए इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ नंबर वन. ओके, देन इफ यू हैव बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ नंबर जीरो जीरो. बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग नंबर जीरो वन. दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ नंबर वन वन एंड दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ नंबर वन जीरो. So if you take any two adjacent cells, I mean adjacent bits, again one bit is changed, here also one bit is changed, here also one bit is changed, and even you can take this one and you can take this one, between the last one and the first one only one bit is changed. Last mein aur first mein sirf ek hi bit ka change hai. In the same way here also C complement means 0 and C means 1. This is 0 0 0 1 1 1 and 1 0. Theek hai, itna clear hai. ओके, सी वी विल डू एवरीथिंग स्टेप बाय स्टेप. हम सब कुछ स्टेप बाय स्टेप करेंगे. आई विल नॉट डू एनीथिंग दैट विल मेक यू गेट कन्फ्यूज. तो हम लोग सब कुछ स्टेप बाय स्टेप कवर करने वाले हैं. ओके, नाउ दिस समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग हैपनिंग हियर. इफ आई एम लुकिंग एट दिस सेल, दिस सेल इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग 000 एंड दिस सेल इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग 100. Okay, why I'm writing 100 is because this row is A and here we have B complement, C complement. Now this cell is representing 000 and this cell is representing 001. Maine yahan par 001 kyun likha? Why I've written 001? Why I've written 001? Why I've not written 100? Yahan par maine 001 kyun likha? Because of this order. Inka jo order hai, the order of variables mentioned in the function. Because of that order, I have to write these numbers in the same order, right? So here, this is representing A, this is representing B, this is representing C. This is representing A, this is representing B, this is representing C. Same order, jo function mein order follow kiya gaya hai variable ka, in the same order, you have to write these numbers, okay? So here, this is representing again 0, 1, 0, correct? Let me use the same color. So this is representing 0, 1, 0. This is representing 0, 1, 1. This is representing 0, 1, 1, 0. This is 1, 1, 1. This is 1, 0, 0. This is 1, 0, 1. Here, if you look at this one, then this is 0, 0, 1. This is 1, 0, 1. This is 0, 1, 1. This is 1, 1, 1. This one is 0, 1, 0. This is 1, 1, 0. Okay? Now, because I have changed the variable that I have written here, यहाँ पर जो मैंने row के अंदर जो variable लिखा है, the variable I have written in the row and the variable I have written in the column, these are two different variables. So because I am using two different variables, that is why what these cells are representing, that will also change. ये जो cells जो represent कर रही है, ये भी आपके पास change हो जाएगा. Clear? Clear? Now in this case, if you write the equivalent decimal value. This is representing a decimal value 1, 0. This is representing a decimal value 1. This is representing a decimal value 2. This is representing a decimal value 3. Decimal value 4, decimal value 5, decimal value 6, decimal value 7. In the same way, in this case, this is representing a decimal value 1, 0. This is representing a decimal value 1. This is 2, this is 3. This is 4, this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. Again, I'm saying the way you are going to represent these cells, these numberings can change. अब यहाँ पर row के अंदर क्या value को represent कर रहे हैं, किस variable को represent कर रहे हैं और column के अंदर किस variable को represent कर रहे हैं, because of that, these numberings will change. ओके, आई होप इट इज क्लियर, इतना आप सभी के साथ क्लियर होगा. ओके, आई होप दिस मच इज क्लियर. ओके फाइन. नाउ सेम थिंग कैन बी ऑब्जर्व विद अ फोर वेरिएबल के मैप. सेम चीजें हम फोर वेरिएबल के मैप के साथ भी रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं. लेट अस अज्यूम दैट वी हैव द फॉलोइंग फंक्शन एफ ऑफ ए कॉमा बी कॉमा सी कॉमा डी एंड दिस फंक्शन इज हैविंग द वैल्यूज समीशन 0, 1, 3, 7, 9, 11. 0, 1, 3, 7, 9, 11. Okay, we will see how we can represent these values. Hum sabhi cheezon ko step by step cover karenge. Now, what I'm doing here is, I'm doing something special. I'm representing AB here and I'm representing CD here. Okay, and just for a purpose, because I want to answer something better, then I'm going to represent AC here and I'm going to represent BD here. So, yahan par jo values hain, so I've changed these values. I'm representing AC, I'm not representing BD. Right? I could have done something like this. I could have represented CD here and AB here. Main wo bhi kar sakta tha, but just for fun, just to make you understand, I'm representing AC and BD. Okay? So, that means, ye jo cell hai, the way numbering in these two cells will go, that will change. Okay, this is representing again 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. Okay, clear? Now, let us write the equivalent values. So, this is representing all zeros. This is 0, 0, 0, 1. This is 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. This one is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay, and in the second cell, now here it will be a little tricky. Writing here will be a little tricky. Yahan pe likhna thoda sa tricky hoga. Because I have to write in this manner. I have to write first A, then I have to write B, then I have to write C, and then I have to write D. So here this value will be 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, 0, 0, 1, 1. 0, 0, 1, 0. Again, 0, 1 0 0. Right, that means I've taken these values 0 1 here, I've written 0 0 over there. Okay, so again here 1 1, here we have 1 0, and in between we have 0 0 0 0. Right, and here we have 0 1 0 1 0 1, and in between we have 0 1 here, 0 1 here, and 0 1 here. Okay, I'm so sorry, I think I've made a mistake here. I'm so sorry. I'm such a duffer sometimes. So this is representing 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. These are the values that each of these cells is representing. Okay? Clear? Now let us write the numbers. In sab ki jo numbers hai, let us try to understand and write the numbers for each of these cells. So this is representing a decimal value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I'm so sorry. Again, this is a mistake. This is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, these will be the numbers here. Now, in this second one, this is representing 0, 2, correct? Ye kya value hogi aapke paas? 2 hogi, right? And this value will be your 10. This value will be 8. This value will be 1. This is 3, this one is value which is 11, right? So we have 0, 2, 4, 8, 8 plus 3 is 11. This one will be value 9. This is representing the value 13. This is representing the value 12. This is representing the value which is 14. This is representing 15. This one is representing value 7. This is representing a value 6. This is representing a value 4. This is representing a value 5. In this manner, they are representing some decimal numbers. Okay, clear hai? I hope it is clear. How I am going to write this? Kis tarah se likhna hai? Wo sabhi aapke sath clear hona chahiye. Now after this, I have written that ABCD is equal to summation 0137911. So ye jo summation hai, summation is representing the min terms, right? Min terms. Or you can say the product term. So the first product term is having a value at 0. So that means here I have value 1 and here also I have value 1. The next we have for 1. So here I have a value 1 as well as here also I have a value 1. Okay. Next is 3. So 3 is represented here. So yahan par aapke paas value 1 hai and here 3 is represented here. So here also I have a value 1. Next one is 7. So here I have a value 1. And here you can see I have a value 1. Then we have 9. So 9 comes up here I have 1 and here also I have 1. Then we have 11. So 11 means here I have a value 1. And in this case also you can check here I have a value 1. So is tarike se bata sakte ho what are the locations in the K map? They are assuming a value 1. So kahan ka par value 1 hai yahan par? We have value 1 here. We have a value 1 in these two locations. We have a value 1 in these two locations. We have a value 1 in these two locations. One here and one here. Okay, clear hai? Okay, so first of all, let us just understand how can you fill these values? How can you represent the functions in the K-map? Bas abhi aapko itna samajhna hai, you only have to understand how can you represent a function using K-map. Okay, okay. So jaise, if you have a function with two variables, which is AB. So I can make a K-map for this AB. I'm taking a variable A here. I'm taking a variable B here. And in this function, it is having one in two locations. I'm just going to represent both of these two locations using the K-map. So this is representing 0, 1 and this is representing 1, 0. So in location 0, 1, we are having a 1. In location 1, 0, we are having a 1. The same thing can be done here. Aap yahan par bhi dekh sakte hain. Actually, this is only difference here is, instead of writing 0, 1, I have written B complement and B. Instead of writing 0, 1, I have written A complement and A. So both of these two K-maps are representing the same thing. Dono jo K-map hai, wo ek hi cheez ko represent kar rahe hain. Okay? In the same way, this is a three-variable K-map. Three-variable K-map. Here we are having three variables. We have the variable ABC. These are representing their decimal values. Jo bhi combinations hai, whatever combinations you have, it is representing the decimal values of those combinations. And this is representing the value of the function. So ye kya kar raha hai, apni function ki value ko represent kar raha hai. So this function is assuming a value 1 here, which is at the location 2. It is assuming a value 1 here, which is at the location 4. It is having a value 1 at the location 5. It is having a value 1 at the location 7. So in sabhi location par ye value 1 le raha hai. So if I represent the same with the help of min term, that I can say this is a function for the variable ABC, and this variable, this function is assuming a value 1 at the location 2. It is having a value 1 for 4. It is having a value 1 for 5. It is having a value 1 for 7. So is tarike se I can also represent the same thing with the help of the function representation. Okay, and I can put all of these values in the K-map. If you are putting all of these values now in the K-map, these locations will be having value 1. So I think you can analyze it. Aap isko samajh sakte hain. You can try and analyze this function. Okay. Now this is representing a 4-variable K-map. So in this 4-variable K-map, these are the functions which is A, B, C, D. So we have 4 variables. We have a variable A, we have a variable B, we have a variable C, and we have a variable D. Now this 4-variable K-map is assuming a value 1 at the location 3, 4, 5, at the location 7, at the location 10, at the location 12, at the location 14 and 15. So I can also represent the same with the help of this. I can say the function is A, B, C, D, and this function is assuming a value 1 at the location 3, at the location 4, at the location 5, at the location 7, then at the location 10, then 12, then 14, and then 15. So these are the locations where this is having a value 1. And I can also fill all of these values in this k-map. So k-map mein jahan jahan par ye locations hai, for example, here I'm representing in every row, I'm representing the variable AB. In every column, I'm representing a value CD. Okay. And now basically it's very easy to remember these values, right? Every time you do not have to calculate that this is representing what location. You can just say it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So just have to remember these values. Ye jo numbering ki values hai, if you remember these numbering values, now filling out this k-map will become very easy. Is k-map ko fill karna aapke liye bahut zyada easy ya fir bahut zyada aasan ho jayega. Okay, I'll take more examples, then you will understand how easy it is to make the k-maps. K-maps ko banana kitna aasan hai, I'll take a few examples. So again, this is, you can see one more example. So this is a function with the help of three variables, and these variables are having a value 1 at a, b, c complement, a, b, c, and a complement, b complement, c. So I can make this k-map. So here for rows, I'm taking the variable a, and for columns, I'm taking a variable bc. So the first location is a, b, c complement. So I can take a, b, this is variable a, I can take b, c complement. So this is the location which is representing a, b, c complement. Then we have a, b, c. So this is the location which is representing a, b, and c. And then we have a complement, b complement, c. So this location is representing a complement, b complement, and c. Okay, so this is how you can represent the same function using the k-map. Now again, this is a four variable k-map. So yahan par aapke paas four variable k-map hai. Now this again, something easy, you can understand more easily how you can fill this table more easily. Kaise fill kar sakte hain? So this one is representing 0, 1, 0, 0, that is having a value 4. This is representing 0, this is 1, 0, 1, 0, that is 10. This is 0, 1, 1, 0, that is 6. This is 1, 0, 1, 1, which is the value, that is 11, right? 8 plus 3 is 11. And this is 1, 1, 0, 1, which is representing a value total 13, right? So 8 plus 4 plus 1 is 13, okay? Now I can directly make a k-map, and in this k-map, I can directly go to the location 4. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here we have 1. And then I can go to the location 10, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So this is location 10. So in the location 10, it is representing a value for this variable. This is representing a value 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in this location 6, I can represent this min term. Then we have, this is representing 11. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So in the location 11, we are having a value 1. And here we have 13. So again, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So this is representing 13. At the location 13, we are having a 1. So in this way, it is very easy to fill the k-map. Making the k-map, filling the k-map is very easy. If you have four variable functions, k-maps are particularly used till four variables. अगर आपके पास कुछ फंक्शंस हैं जो फोर वेरिएबल्स के फंक्शन हैं, तो हम मैक्सिमम वी यूज़ केमैप फॉर टू वेरिएबल फंक्शन, वी यूज़ केमैप फॉर थ्री वेरिएबल फंक्शन, वी यूज़ केमैप फॉर फोर वेरिएबल फंक्शंस, बट वी कैन ऑल्सो क्रिएट केमैप फॉर फाइव वेरिएबल, बट मेकिंग अ केमैप फॉर फाइव वेरिएबल इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग एज वेल एज इट विल बी ट्रिकी, राइट? इन योर एग्जामिनेशन मैक्सिमम यू विल गेट अप टू फोर वेरिएबल्स. आपके एग्जाम में आपको मैक्सिमम फोर वेरिएबल्स के तक ही के मैप आएगा. यू विल नॉट गेट अ के मैप फॉर फाइव वेरिएबल्स. आपको पांच वेरिएबल का के मैप नहीं आएगा. यू विल ओनली गेट के मैप फॉर थ्री वेरिएबल्स एज वेल एज फोर वेरिएबल्स. ओके, सो आई होप दैट यू अंडरस्टूड हाउ टू फिल अ के मैप. आपको समझ में आया होगा कि के मैप को कैसे फिल कर सकते हैं. ओके, नाउ लेट अस लुक एट हाउ कैन यू मेक पेयर्स इन द के मैप. के मैप में किस किस पेयर्स को बनाया जा सकता है, लेट अस लुक एट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.